Okay, the next one you're going to look at is the common file type for ANSYS. So we have a few types. So we look at the first two first. One is called database file. If you open up ANSYS, the file format will be in something.db. Right? So if you save something in a folder, and you see the extension of the file is something.db or jobname.db, means it's fall under database file. So if your file.db file is missing, means you're not able to run the simulation software. You need to redo all the setting because this .db file or database file will record your data, your input data and output data. So for example, before you run simulation, you will need to input your loading, your constraint. Then every value that you put inside there in the software, it will save inside the database file or extension file .db. This is the first type of the file. So for example, you want to share the file to your friend so that your friend will able to see your results, can see your results. You send this .db file to your friend. If your friend is using ANSYS, then you can share what is your input, what is your result. Second one is a log file. Log file, the extension file extension is .log, right? Jobname.log, log. So it's a ASC type 2 file. This file, log file, is a general SOP for all the software. Every time you log in, there is a log file. So even you use a Microsoft Word, you have a log file. Same with ANSYS also. When you log in and you start to press the create something, it will start to log. Means it will record the step that you do in the software. Okay. Now the log file, it will allow the user or maybe your friend, if you share the log file to your friend, we're able to see what step that you do on your computer. Okay. And also this is a trace file where when you do your exam or when you do your when you do your examination or you do your certification, most of the time we will request for your log file. Or there is a software that check balance the log file. So these are the two file that we will have for ANSYS. One is .db, one is .log, log. Database file and log file. So when I ask you to, okay, give me the database file, you should copy the correct file format. Okay, don't give me the whole folder, but I'll need request for a certain particular file. So once you have your database file and log file, there is a special folder that created in the ANSYS directory. It's called error file. Means all the error that you get in the software, either you key in the wrong mesh number or wrong mesh type and all this, it will come out, it will record it in the error file. It's not in the log file. So error file also in the ASC type 2 format. This is a computer file format. It will capture all the error message. The extension will be .err. Okay, so we will have three types of file. First one, database file. What is the extension of the database for database file? Pretty bar?
DB, sir.
Your DB, a log file?
LOG.
Yeah, correct. So, and then another one is the most important one, your result file. So, result file, you have three. Here, I give you example. So, you have three types of, okay, there's a typo error here. Float, float analysis, FLOD. There's no L here, right? So, for example, when you have a structure analysis, you generate result. The extension will be .rst. And if you simulate on thermal analysis, it will be .rth. And if you do float analysis, your extension will become RTS, RST. Correct. I think I need to check. The float type analysis is not RST. It's, I think it's RF something. Okay, I will come back to this file type one. This is not RTS. RTS is a structure file. So again, what is important is that the flow analysis will give you the type of extension. Okay. Another one on ANSYS is that it's a cat neutral. What mean by cat neutral means it's able to read computational aid drawing from other software also. So textbook definition, they call it bi-directional, means two-directional CAT connection. Read with ANSYS. You don't need to install all this software, and the ANSYS can open all this file. So these are the example. For example, you should heard before what is AutoCAD in DWG, drawing, CATIA, Ciclio, Autodesk Inventor, NX, SolidEdge, and SolidWorks. So I think you're more familiar with AutoCAD or SolidWorks, and also CATIA. So Autodesk Inventor, most properly from those ID, interior designer, they will use Inventor. Okay, but however, ANSYS is able to support all this well. So don't worry if your customer or your friend send you different file. These all are CAD drawing. It's a CAD drawing. A drawing file that you're able to read using ANSYS Workbench. You don't need to memorize all the extension. It's just that in general, just let you know that you can create a model using CAD software, using AutoCAD, using SolidWorks, using SolidEdge, Ciclio, or Autodesk Inventor, CATIA, SolidEdge also. Okay, so these are the software that allow you to do 3D modeling. Then later you import the file inside the workbench so that you can read. Of course, you can create the 3D model inside the workbench by using the modeler. Okay. What else? Okay, CAD reader means you're able to read other file also. Yeah. So the software that we mentioned also lah. Okay. In general means that from today lecture, you're able to answer what kind of software that ANSYS can support, especially when it comes to technical drawing. So okay, so if you go to interview later on, maybe or go to work later on, maybe you'll come across all these question, right? So your customer will pass you some 3D file for you to do analysis in the ANSYS. So all these source that you can ask your customer to create a model for you, and then you generate the result for them. Geometry export means that you done you draw something, a 3D model in the ANSYS workbench, then you can export the file in all these format. You can export your file in IGS. So if you are in the manufacturing plant, like precision metal stamping, or in the plastic molding, then most of the time you will deal with a .igs file. Meaning if you deal with the factory that do manufacturing and you deal with the draft man, then most of the time you will request, or the draft man will request for IGS file. IGS means it's a 3D model file that in IGS format or iImage file, right? Step file also can, and all these are just format that you can export. Data flow, I think this one you are familiar since you are ANSYS user. You will see that from on the screen here, you will see that this user actually he's running two simulation in one go. So on the left here, you will see that the user start with the A process, which is fall under Fluent simulation, and the B process here or B project here is under static structural analysis. So, and then how you connect the data from project A to project B is through connection, right? It's through a connection line. I think you're familiar with all these things. So if you look at this diagram, so this user is intended to pass information from the front to stack structural analysis from the geometry, both of the project A and B use the same geometry, and the solution from the flow, from the fluid flow simulation, connect to the structural analysis setup here. So means what you solve, what the equation that you use for Fluent, you continue to adopt by the static structure here. And in the ANSYS software, you will see all these symbols. For example, we are favorite. We always want to see the tick mark, a green tick mark. Means if you see a tick mark, means the software itself in the ANSYS already set the correct, or there is a data for it to analyze. Engineering data here, most of the time, is the material data. So if you see on the screen here, you see a tick here means for project B, you already include the data there. And if you see a question mark means it's still unknown, you haven't do properly the setup, and the software do not know what is the geometry yet for the analysis. So what mean by a complete simulation means that after a complete simulation, you will see all the tick here. The question mark will change to tick mark on project page here. Okay. So this is how we read from the project schematic in the ANSYS system. Okay. Any question on this page on the data flow? Pritiba, any question?
Hi, sir. Sorry, yeah. Sir. It's the line is been cutting over there.
What line? Okay,
sir. No question, sir. My what? Line here. My line.
Oh, okay. So okay, where do you lost me? Where do you lost me just now?
The last part when you were talking about.
Which one? What do I talk?
The final sentence.
What do I say?
About
what
the data, say? Data or
data? on the engineering data.
Engineering. Correct. I lost
okay.
that.
Yeah. So what do you mean if you see the tick mark there? What does it mean?
Okay.
Yeah, what does it mean?
What do I mean with the tick mark there is we already key in the engineering data.
Okay. But what happened if you see the question mark there? What happened? What does it mean with the question mark?
The question mark is means we haven't key in the geometry yet. We haven't import the model yet.
Okay. So on the screen here, you see there's a purple line that what does it mean? What does it mean? This line. What does it mean? Yeah. What do you understand by the line? Purple line.
What I can understand is once we get the solution from the fluid flow, so it's continued to the setup.
Okay. Good.
Okay.
Okay. Then the next one is on the geometry. So for ANSYS, I think you heard the design modeler or space clamp before. It depends on the version that you have. By default setting, you will see design modeler. If you want to use space clamp, you need to buy this function. Okay, it's an additional function from ANSYS. Okay. You can create the geometry or you can just import from the existing CAD file. Means you import from other software, for example AutoCAD or SOLIDWORKS, right? You import there so that you get your simulation. So all these are the file type that we mentioned just now. Okay. Right. So I'm not expecting you to memorize, but at least you can recall some of them. For example, step file, space clamp file from ANSYS itself, design modeler, SOLIDWORKS, and AutoCAD here is not here, but IGS file. So if you go to work, I think most of the time the drafter will ask or request IGS form, okay, IGS, right? So these are the 3D modeler file. Basic analysis workflow, I think you're familiar with it. Means we will set things according to a numbering here. So you insert, for example, in this example, you insert the engineering data. After that, you do geometry, then you do meshing, then you do some setup for the loading and boundary condition. Then you run set for the solution. And after that, step number 7 here, you don't need to do anything. You just need to extract the result from here. So after you run the, after at the stage of solution here, after you run the, click the run button, when your result become converged or you reach the converge, then the automatic the result here will become a tick mark. So if you get a triangular shape with the exclamation mark, means something wrong with the calculation. There's an error there. Yeah, so for fluid analysis, you actually have two main function in ANSYS. One is called CFX, which is a fluid flow simulation. Another one is called Fluent. Okay, so one is called CFX simulation, and the one is called Fluent simulation. Both of it, we use it to simulate fluid. However, there is some limitation on the CFX. All right. So be careful which one you choose. Huh? So this one is all the system that we have in ANSYS. This analysis system is the one that we mentioned. For example, Fluent CFS is the analysis system. So you need to choose when you start the project. So if you choose CFS, then there's a limitation there. If you choose Flow, then there are more settings over there. And for mechanical, is always under static structural to do the loading and all this. As steady state thermal is for thermal analysis. Transient thermal also on thermal. Electrostatic is more on the electromagnetic wave. And some of it's on the privation, electric also here. So this this list that you see on the screen here is the one that on the left hand side of the ANSYS software. So you need to click on it before you can start anything, before you can see all the workflow here. Okay. Space clamp meshing. So if you have a space clamp meshing, there's a workflow over there. So it means you import the space frame function. Then you will see it will appear in the project window. Okay. Workbench, this one I think you are familiar with the setting. So on the left hand side here is the analysis system that there's a list that I give you on the screen just now. So you need to be careful on choosing, and you just click and drag into a project schematic here. Okay. Make sure your project schematic is clean and neat. There's no extra analysis system that you accidentally drag and drop here. So if you drag and drop here, then you'll create additional input for the project. Okay. This one is if you want to look at the file panel, then you just open up. It's just below the column there. Another one is called this one is inside the project. I think you're familiar. The third one is the outline plane. Also when you open up the toolbox on the left, then you'll see the setting on the right here. Or sometimes you click the option that you have inside the project, you will see something pop up on the right hand side. Okay, so this one is the you editing based on if you have a ready value. For example, the length of the structure, the limit that you have according to a certain standard, for example, pipe thickness and all this, then you can constrain by using the setting over here. Solution, this one also, some of the, if you click solution, you will see the property of the solution. You can change accordingly. Right, so every time you click on the something on the project schematic, there will be something come up on the right hand side. So you can do setting. So this is a good example when you have a complete simulation where you see all the tick, the green tick here. This is what we want. Okay, this is what we want. Of course, we need to see the result whether is it logic or not. But this is the workflow that we are intended to have. Okay. These are some of the message that you have. Progress. So progress plane is that when you run or when you input the model, for example, when you import the model, you will see that the progress bar come up. So if you have a fast computer, most of the time you won't see this one because the process happened too fast. It will just pop up and then it will just disappear. If you have, because the progress run very fast, you just update. For example, in this case, you update the model. Then if you have a very fast computer, then the progress will run very fast and this one will just close itself. Okay, these are the general outview of ANSYS. Let me stop the recording.